Hello guys, welcome on Tesla Adventures. In this video, we'll learn about all the concepts of acceleration, velocity and energy in SHM. So starting with acceleration of SHM, let us assume a equation of SHM which is x is equal to a sine omega t. And I am assuming that this particle is starting from the mean position because I have assumed its initial phase to be zero. So this is the displacement of the particle at some time t. Now to find out the velocity of the particle, we can differentiate this displacement with respect to time. And that would be equal to a omega cos omega t. So v will be equal to a omega cos omega t. Now to find out the acceleration, we again differentiate this velocity with respect to time. Therefore it would be minus a square, in fact a omega square sine omega t. So this is the acceleration of SHM. A is equal to minus a omega square sine omega t. Now very first thing which we have to notice, that when we have assumed the displacement equation as of the sine omega t, then the velocity equation comes to be cos omega t, which means that there is a phase difference between displacement and velocity, and this phase difference is pi by 2, and velocity leads the displacement by a phase of pi by 2. Now if we see the phase difference between displacement and the acceleration, then you can see that the acceleration is shifted by a phase of pi, and it is in fact leading the displacement by a phase difference of pi. So if the question comes in this way, that we have to find out that phase difference between displacement and velocity of SHM, then it is pi by 2 and velocity is leading. And if we have to find out the phase difference between acceleration and displacement of SHM, then it is pi and acceleration is leading the displacement. Now this is called as the maximum value of acceleration, and it is referred as a naught. So this is minus a naught sine omega t. Okay, so this is the maximum peak value of acceleration. This now a naught is equal to a omega square, and you can also see that this a sine omega t is equal to x. So we can substitute the value of a sine omega t as x in this equation, and therefore the acceleration a will be equal to minus omega square x. This result can also be obtained, and this results can be concluded by this equation, that we know that f is equal to minus kx in SHM, and f is also equal to ma. So we can equate these two equations, that ma is equal to minus kx, and this a is equal to minus k upon m into x. Now we already know that this k upon a is omega square, so this acceleration is minus omega square x. So this is the acceleration which is in the function as a function of x, and this is the acceleration which is as a function of time. Now at x is equal to 0, which is the mean position in this case, so in x is equal to 0, the acceleration of the particle is zero, and we can say that the magnitude of acceleration of the particle is minimum at mean position. Now at x is equal to plus or minus a, the magnitude of acceleration of the particle is maximum, and that a maximum is equal to omega square a. So the maximum acceleration in SHM is omega square a. Now if we draw the graph that represents the acceleration versus displacement, then that graph would be a is equal to minus omega square x, and hence this is a relationship which represents a straight line, y is equal to minus mx. So this is the graph which is a straight line, and this would be the straight line. Now this angle theta, if this is theta, then tan theta would be equal to omega square, and the maximum value of acceleration is omega square a, and it is at the position minus a, because this acceleration is always directed towards the mean position. What I mean to say is the fact that if this is the mean position and this is the extreme positions, and particle is somewhere at this position, then the acceleration of the particle would be towards the mean position, towards O. And if the particle is situated somewhere at this position, then also its acceleration would be towards O. So if the particle is situated at negative extreme minus A, then the acceleration would be pointing towards positive direction, therefore it is plus omega square A. And when the particle is at a positive extreme plus A, then acceleration would be pointing towards negative direction, so that would be minus omega square A. So there are two important things which is to note. So the first important thing is the fact that acceleration of the particle which is performing SHM is always directed towards the mean position. So the acceleration is always towards the mean position. And the second most important thing, which is important as far as exams are concerned, so that is the magnitude of SHM, magnitude of acceleration. In fact, this is acceleration. So the magnitude of acceleration in SHM is maximum at extreme positions. You can see that it is omega square a, and it is zero at mean position. Okay, so mean position is in fact a position where the net force acting on the particle is zero. So we can say this thing in the way that the acceleration, the position where acceleration of the particle in SHM is zero, is also called as mean position. So this is the acceleration versus displacement graph. Now if we move on the graphical representation of acceleration with time, then we can see that the equation of acceleration was minus omega square a sine omega t. So this is a equation of minus sine theta, and therefore the graph of minus sine theta would be like that. But you have to note one thing, that this equation is only valid when I have assumed that the displacement was x is equal to a sine omega t. So if SHM is occurring according to this equation, then this acceleration is valid. Now if this displacement equation was the equation of cos, then the acceleration would be the equation of cos. So acceleration dependency on time will depend on the dependency of displacement on time. So when we have assumed the displacement as x is equal to a sine omega t, then the acceleration is minus omega square a sine omega t. So it is a graph of minus sine omega t, like that. Now let us move on the velocity of SHM. So we have already encountered the velocity dependence on time in the previous acceleration section, but we'll again discuss the velocity separately. So assuming the equation of SHM to be x is equal to a sine omega t, and assuming that the initial phase of the SHM was zero, so to obtain the term of velocity, we differentiate this displacement with respect to the time, and therefore it is a omega cos omega t. So again, I will remind you that the phase difference between the velocity and the displacement is pi by 2, and velocity is leading the displacement by a phase of pi by 2. This term is called as the maximum velocity. This is v naught cos omega t. Now you can also write this cos omega t, in fact v naught, as a omega, and this cos omega t as under root of 1 minus sine square omega t. You can write cos theta as under root 1 minus sine square theta. So you can substitute the value of sine theta, sine omega t, from this. So v will be equal to a omega under root of 1 minus x square by a square. So v will be equal to in fact, this is the magnitude of velocity only. So v will be equal to a omega under root of a square minus x square upon a square. So cancelling this a with a, so the speed in SHM v is equal to omega under root of a square minus x square. Now you can see that at x is equal to plus or minus a, which are the extreme positions of SHM, the velocity is 0, and at x is equal to 0, which is the mean position in this case, the velocity is maximum and it is equal to a omega. So this is the relation of velocity with the displacement. Now we are moving forward on the graphical representation of the velocity. So first of all, let us represent the velocity with as a function of time. So when we have assumed that x is equal to a sine omega t is the equation of SHM, then velocity will be equal to a omega cos omega t, and therefore the graph of velocity with time would be the graph of cos theta, and this would be the graph. Now if we draw the graph of velocity with displacement, then we can see that velocity was equal to omega under root of a square minus x square. Squaring both the sides, this is v square is omega square a square minus omega square x square. This can be written as as v square plus omega square x square is equal to omega square a square, and dividing both the sides by omega square a square, so this is v square upon omega square a square plus this is x square upon a square, and this is equal to 1. So this is a equation of ellipse, and this ellipse has this axis, this semi-major axis, this one, as omega a, and this semi-major axis, in fact this is semi-minor axis, this one is semi-minor axis, and this is semi-major axis, so it is a. So it depends on that what is the value of omega, so it will be relative term. So this is the maximum velocity, which is a omega, and this is minus a omega, this is plus a, and this is minus a. So the graph of velocity with displacement would be a graph which is a ellipse. Now let us move forward on the energy of SHM. So first of all, let us see that the velocity, if x is equal to a sine omega t, then v is equal to a omega cos omega t, and acceleration is equal to minus a omega square sine omega t. Okay, so now when we talk about the kinetic energy, So the kinetic energy is half m v square. So this kinetic energy would be half m omega square a square cos square omega t. And if we talk about the potential energy, then it is half k x square, where k is equal to m omega square. We all know that. And x is equal to a sin omega t. So x square would be equal to a square sin square omega t. So you can see that kinetic energy is depending on cos square theta, and potential energy is depending on sin square theta. Again, this dependency depends on the fact that you have assumed x as a sin omega t. If you have you were assuming x as a cos omega t, then this would be sin square and this would be cos square. So in this case, this is cos square and this is sin square. If we find out the total energy of SHM, so the total energy of SHM is potential energy plus kinetic energy, and that is half m omega square a square, and this cos square plus sin square would be equal to 1. Now you can see that the maximum potential energy is also equal to the total energy, and that is also equal to the maximum kinetic energy, and this is equal to half m omega square a square. And you can see that if we find out, let us suppose, that the potential energy, we know that it is half k x square, where k is equal to m omega square and this is x square. So at x is equal to plus or minus a, the potential energy will be maximum, and that would be equal to the half m omega square a square, and the kinetic energy would be zero at this position. And at x is equal to, in fact I can write down the kinetic energy also. So kinetic energy is half m v square, where v is the speed and v is equal to omega square. V square is equal to omega square into a square minus x square. So this is the kinetic energy, and this kinetic energy would be minimum at x is equal to plus minus a, extreme positions. So this would be zero. But at x is equal to zero, mean position, the potential energy will be minimum, and that would be equal to zero, and the kinetic energy would be maximum, and that would be half m omega square a square. So this is the variation of kinetic and potential energies. Now if we find out the graphical representation of kinetic energy with time and the graphical representation of potential energy with time, then you can see that the kinetic energy was the function of cos square theta. So this would be half m omega square a square cos square omega t, and the potential energy is equal to half m omega square a square sin square omega t. So this is the graph of cos square omega t, and this is the graph of sin square omega t. So these are the dependency of kinetic and potential energy on time. Now if we find out the dependency of kinetic and potential energy on displacement x, so you can see that potential energy is equal to half m omega square x square, and kinetic energy is equal to half m omega square into a square minus x square. So these both relationships are of parabola, but this parabola is opening towards positive y-axis and this parabola is opening towards negative y-axis. So this red one would be the graph of potential energy, and this blue one would be the graph of kinetic energy, which is the inverted parabola. So the maximum energy would be half m omega square a square. And if we wish to find out these points where these graph intersects, so let us suppose that this is A and this is B. So the at the point of intersection of these graphs, at points A and B, you can see that potential energy will be equal to the kinetic energy because both the graphs are intersecting each other. So you can substitute the value that half m omega square x square is the potential energy, and that is half m omega square into a square minus x square. So cancelling this with this, you can see that 2x square is equal to a square and x is equal to plus minus a by root 2. This is the value of x. So at x is equal to either plus a by root 2 or either at minus a by root 2, the kinetic and the potential energies are equal. And if we wish to find out the time, then we can easily say that for the first time in SHM, when the particle is at x is equal to a by root 2, the phase at this position for the first time at x is equal to plus a by root 2, the phase is equal to pi by 4, because sine 45 degrees is equal to 1 by root 2. So if this phase is equal to omega t, then this time is equal to t by 8. You can substitute the value of omega as 2 pi by t. So this at this time, for the first time, the kinetic energy and the potential energy in SHM are equal to each other. Now let us find out the average values of kinetic and the potential energies. Now there are two kind of average values. The first average value is calculated with time, and therefore we know that kinetic energy is half m omega square a square cos square omega t, and potential energy is half m omega square a square sine square omega t. So if we have to find out the average value of the kinetic energy over the full cycle, then it would be half m omega square a square average of cos square omega t. So the average value of cos square omega t is equal to half, and therefore the kinetic energy average will be equal to 1 by 4 m omega square a square. And similarly, if we have to find out the average value of potential energy with time, then it is half m omega square a square sine square omega t average, and the average of sine square omega t is also equal to half. Therefore the potential energy will be 1 by 4 m omega square a square when we are calculating it on averaging it on time. So you can see that average kinetic energy and average potential energy are equal when they are averaged on time. But when they are averaged on position, then let us find out the average kinetic or average potential energy in the position 0 to A. So from 0 to A, if we write down the potential energy, then it is half m omega square x square. To find out the average potential energy, we can integrate this potential energy from 0 to A. So it would be half m omega square x square into dx, and dividing it by the total interval, which is A. So limit from 0 to A. So this is half m omega square into x cube by 3, and limit would be from 0 to a. So this is half, in fact 1 by 6, m omega square a square, the average potential energy with position. Now if we find out the average kinetic energy in interval 0 to a, so the kinetic energy is half m omega square a square minus x square. So the average kinetic energy will be equal to half m omega square a square minus x square into dx divided by a, integrating from 0 to a. So this is half m omega square by a. Now the integration of a square will be a square x, minus the integration of x square will be x cube by 3, and the limit would be 0 to a and 0 to a. So this is half m omega square by a square, in fact a, and this would be a cube minus a cube by 3. So this is 1 by 3 m omega square a square. So this is the average kinetic energy over the position. Now you can also see that the average potential and the average kinetic energy are not equal in this case when they are averaged over the position. So this was the complete analysis of acceleration, velocity and energy in SHM. And in the next video, I'll be bringing the numericals which are based on these quantities. Thank you.